Hello gamers, it's Nice, and I hope everyone that skips the quest dialogue is having a nice day. Today, I wanted to discuss how important lore is to an MMO, and how much lore, if any, is needed for upcoming MMO Ashes of Creation before its Alpha 2 launch. However, for today's video, I wanted to do something special, something a little different for us. I wanted to do a shout out to some glorious members of our community and a collaboration I hope you all will enjoy. Today, we are joined by Cash of Loreforged. Loreforged is a great podcast with hosts Sunny, Cash, and Jibs, and has you covered for all things Ashes of Creation lore with a lot of videos on their YouTube channel as well. You'll find links to all of those in the description. I just couldn't cover Ashes of Creation lore for the first time without getting these guys involved. So without further ado, let's discuss how important lore is for a MMO. Lore is quite important to a lot of people. This is obviously true for both single-player games and multiplayer games. In fact, some people only focus on the RPG portion of MMORPGs. Lore helps shape a world. It helps provide you a reason on why you're doing what you're doing. It almost gives direction to the player, further helping them get immersed in this digital world. Without lore or narrative, you might as well be playing a game purely focused on combat or, you know, attempt to just be another battle royale in the gaming industry. But simply just having lore isn't enough, is it? There's good lore and there's bad lore, or rather, lore that doesn't entice the audience enough to care about it. Soulless filler dialogue using the same cliches of the chosen one hero slaying the big bad guy with horns on his head because, you know, reasons. Generic D&D storylines, right? If you don't give the gamer a reason to care about lore or the main story, you end up with someone like me. A player mindlessly skipping through the dialogue and not knowing why they are doing what they are doing. But we know that as soon as we spam this dialogue and this NPC finally finishes talking, there's going to be a huge quest marker that's going to pop up. My compass will be highlighted, pointing where I need to go without having to read that dialogue, and my objective tab will just summarize the quest for me, saying something like, I don't know, slay 10 Vex in the Winstead brothel for Princess Fiona or something. Players need attention grabbers, or else you'll end up with people spamming dialogue so they can reach max level even faster, versus the guy taking his time to learn the world's history in the background and why he's doing that quest. I want to be that player this time around. I want to get fully immersed in Ashes of Creation's lore and story. I don't want a storyline so crap that I rush through it. A lot of lore I feel will be player driven and different on each server with the rise and fall of nodes and just different communities built on these servers, but also with Intrepid's amazing story arc system that allows players to truly shape the world of Vera. But let's hear from Cash of Loreforged on how important lore is to an MMO. And spoiler alert, the guy from Loreforged is kinda into lore, believe it or not.
Hail and well met friends, this is Cash from Loreforged. Our friend Nice Gaming asked us to answer a couple of questions in relation to lore. So getting into the first question here, how important is lore to an MMO? You probably would be able to guess, coming from somebody wearing a Loreforged shirt and being a part of a podcast and content creation team called Loreforged, that we have a pretty strong opinion on lore. We really do believe it's pretty darn essential, and the reasons why are lore really does help to establish your place in the world and makes the world feel rich and alive. It gives your character purpose and gives context to the overall story that you're playing through. Now, for role players, if you happen to be a role player, it really does have a deeper feel. It provides a basis for your character, because we all know role players write backstories for their characters, and gives them a reason to delve into that dungeon or take that trip into that stronghold or that ruin to try and find what the story is behind that particular location. It's important to remember that there's a little bit of role player in every single one of us. Otherwise, you really wouldn't care how your character looks or what they wear or how powerful they happen to be. After all, you are playing a massively multiplayer online role-playing game.
So let's now discuss if we need more lore on Ashes of Creation before Alpha 2. I think there's a lot of value in knowing certain things about an MMO story before getting into it. Ashes of Creation is in a unique situation where it will have a long Alpha 2 in which players will obviously be discovering certain things, completing certain dungeons, and activating key story arcs, as well as doing plenty of the side questing, right? This means that even though Alpha 2 is meant as a testing ground for this work-in-progress MMO, a lot of things will be revealed. Do players need this lore revealed before Alpha 2, though? I don't necessarily think so. I think it gives us testers the opportunity to discover things ourselves. I like most things lore-wise not being known, and it will be fun seeing people piece things together and actively form, you know, lore theories. For example, till this day, I still binge Elden Ring lore videos and trying to piece together mysteries of that world, and that goes to show you that people are really into good lore. I think players don't mind waiting to discover some things themselves. However, let's see what Cash has to say.
So the second question here, how much, if any, lore is needed before Alpha 2? And this one, you might find my answer kind of interesting, because honestly, if people are participating in the Alpha 2 for the right reasons, really don't need any lore. You don't actually need lore, or don't actually need even to set the stage in order to test core systems, explore zone functionality like weather, swimming, falling trees, or picking flowers. There's really no story needed there. But when you do have story, even in the testing of a game, it really allows you a first-hand look at the history of the zone that you're playing in, the personality of its people, where you fit in the grand scheme of the world. So in my humble opinion, lore helps you not just enjoy what you're doing in the game, but it helps you fall in love with the things that you're doing, because your character will have a sense of purpose and belonging. And remember, every time you speed through a quest text or story arc, a developer loses their wings. From all of us here at Loreforged, safe travels, adventures.
I once again want to thank Cash of Loreforged for the collaboration. It would mean a lot to me if you guys sub to their YouTube channel so you can get prepped for that AOC lore that will come in. And of course, once again, a link to their Twitch will be in the description as well. A big thank you to everyone who decided to become YouTube channel members. Truly appreciate the continued support as we sit in Ashes of Creation's waiting room. Please subscribe if you're new, comment your thoughts below on all things lore, and maybe if we get 100 likes, Steven will comment some lore for Loreforged to have something to do as we wait for Alpha 2. And for everyone that stuck around to the end of the video, here's a little example of what you can expect from Loreforged.
Created by the Ten, held the qualities of their creators, and were intended to be entrusted with the stewardship of all creation. However, a rift among the Ten arose regarding the treatment of their new creation. Three of the Ten separated and bestowed upon the ancients the secrets of the essence, leading to a great celestial battle with the remaining seven. This fierce conflict was said to have shaped the very stars and heavens we observe today. Each blow struck between the Ten gave birth to a new star, until the battle's end, when the others and the ancients were banished by the Seven into the void. Recognizing the errors in the creation of the ancients, the Seven decided to divide them.